Hi, I'm Priscila Dauros-Singorenko, and I'm here to talk about the importance of Zeta potential to your EV research. Determination of key physicochemical properties directly influences the outcome of investigations, whether it's to determine EV biological roles, method development, or applications into nanomedicine. This 3D plot shows the latest innovations in advanced single particle analysis by TRPS, where heterogeneous populations can be accurately profiled based on concentration, size, and surface charge, vastly improving the measurement and analysis capabilities. As you may know, our technology, tunable resistive pulse sensing, is known to be the most precise and accurate EV analysis tool in the market. Unlike optical technologies, TRPS, physical-based technology, relies on nanoparticles passing through a nanopore, creating a temporary increase in resistance. The characteristics of this current blockade are used to determine particle concentration, particle size, and particle charge or Zeta potential by measuring the number of pulses, pulse magnitudes, and pulse durations, respectively. QNano, the original TRPS instrument, could be complex to use for some researchers. Nevertheless, to respond to the researchers' need, the EXOID was developed and launched to significantly improve user usability and advance efficiency in terms of time and effort to take measurements. The EXOID implements semi-automation with fully automatic pressure system and resolution of sub 1 Pascal, speeding up the process, improving sensitivity, and minimizing variability. There's also automated stretcher unit, which controls the stretch of the nanopore, an assisted nanopore unblocking mechanism to help measurement with complex samples. What are the TRPS particle concentration and size capabilities? Additionally to monodispersed particle samples, like liposomes or synthetic particles, TRPS can resolve multimodal or polydispersed samples, such as EV samples, with the highest precision. In this example, analysis of quadrimodal polystyrene standards has shown that TRPS can resolve each of the populations by size and concentrations, unlike other single particle technologies such as nanoparticle tracking analysis or other ensemble technologies such as multi-angle dynamic light scattering, which cannot fully resolve these populations. Many of the relevant biological interactions between a particle and the recipient or target cell might depend on Zeta potential. Zeta potential is a measure of effective charge of a particle in a certain medium. It depends on factors such as medium, polar or non-polar, type of electrolyte, salt concentration, and pH. The Zeta potential is defined as the electrostatic potential at the plane of shear between the particle associated and the stationary part of the ionic double layer. Therefore, accurate characterization of EV's Zeta potential is important to meaningful assignations of biological roles. In a synthetic particle mixture, it is assumed that all particles have the same Zeta potential. However, in EV samples, this might not be the case, where highly heterogeneous population is the norm. For monodispersed particle mixes, phase analysis light scattering based on laser Doppler velocimetry, or PALS, might be the most used technique. However, this ensemble technique loses its applicability for polydispersed samples, such as EV-based samples, since with this technique, individual particle sizes and Zeta potentials are not measured. With TRPS, Zeta potential is determined particle by particle by their electrophoretic mobility through a previously calibrated nanopore, providing results that are unbiased from size. In this graph, we show that TRPS can resolve a particle mixture of 1:1 of 400 nanometer charged carboxylated polystyrene CPCs, as shown on the right of the graph, versus 400 nanometer bare polystyrene CPNs on the left of the graph. In contrast, PALS cannot resolve these two populations. Previous and current EXOID-based Zeta potential characterizations can render data as detailed histograms of concentration versus charge or 2D plots of size versus charge. In this histogram of count versus charge, we can see the high sensitivity of TRPS Zeta potential measurements has liposomes made with different phospholipids or different proportion of mixed phospholipids return different Zeta potentials. In this plot, we can see that a pentamodal mix of particles of same sizes and different charge, such as charged carboxylated polystyrene CPC-100 versus bare polystyrene CPN-100s, or magnetic particles versus magnetic particles with DNA are well separated into different populations. So far, particle size and Zeta potential can be determined simultaneously. However, one of the most recent innovations on our TRPS and EXOID technology is the possibility of analyzing data of EV concentration based on size and Zeta potential simultaneously, as shown in this figure. TRPS measurements of Zeta potential are done at very low pressures to keep electrophoresis as the main driving force, resulting in small bias or inflated counts towards highly charged particles. Nevertheless, a new post-processing protocol of classically obtained data can correct the distortion and convert 2D plots into 3D histograms of particle number concentration versus particle diameter and Zeta potential. The correction is purely based on physical principles and not on arbitrary fitting models. For example, here is a 3D plot of a trimodal 2:2:1 CPN 150, CPN 200, and CPC 200 mix, where before data analysis correction, charged carboxylated polystyrene CPC 200 are vastly overrepresented. However, after data analysis correction, bare polystyrene CPN 150 and CPN 200 proportions outweighed the CPC 200 proportion of the mix, as expected for nominal values. In this way, with our TRPS-based Zeta potential sensitivity and resolving power, analyzing Zeta potential in EVs as a key physical-chemical parameter may hold significant utility in many fields of EV research. Characterizing EVs' composition on how certain stimuli can influence the composition of different EV subtypes. For example, some antibiotic treatments used for their antibacterial properties has shown effects on EVs released from mammalian cells, increasing DNA associated with the surface of small EVs, resulting in modification of their adhesion properties. These modified or new discovered roles can be exploited for therapeutic applications, since EV-associated DNA has shown immunomodulatory functions. For example, can suppress inflammatory responses or anti-tumor immune responses. Zeta potential is also useful to assess clinical or pharmaceutical applicability of EV nanoformulations, since EVs already present low immunogenicity and natural cell targeting capabilities. For example, in exogenous drug loading of EVs or loading after separation of EVs from cells, post-loading EV characterization can be done by checking if the drug loading process changed critical parameters of EVs, such as surface charge and size, which can affect the biological interaction in drug delivery studies. Also, storage stability of EV preparations can be assessed due to higher Zeta potential indicating higher repulsion between particles in suspension, suggesting high dispersion stability. EVs have been shown to have critical roles in many different types of cancers by stimulating tumor growth or mediating transfer of drug resistance or manipulating the tumor microenvironment. It's been shown that many and specific cancer EVs present a differential composition and surface charge, for example, as shown for the abundance of sialic acid in EVs, a main contributor of EV charge. Thus, understanding the composition and roles of tumor-secreted EVs have in progression of cancer is essential to develop effective new therapeutics. As mentioned earlier, cancer-derived EVs, which have a differential composition and Zeta potential, may also be exploited as targets of cancer diagnosis, progression, and monitoring treatment efficiency. Current methods mostly rely on detection of cancer EVs by surface markers. However, coupling an extra layer of specificity by determining EV charge will improve the overall performance of the detection tool. And finally, whether it's labeling EVs or developing new capture system, binding of molecules such as aptamers, proteins, antibodies, lectins, DNA or RNA to the surface of the EV can change Zeta potential and can be precisely assessed and profiled in heterogeneous EV samples. Thank you for tuning into Izon Symposium on Zeta Potential and EV Research. If you would like to know more about how TRPS and Zeta Potential can impact your EV research, please contact us at izon.com. We can help to take your EV research to the highest potential with powerful and unparalleled precision and accurate characterization of EVs. From everyone here at Izon, we hope you enjoy the rest of ISEV 21. Thanks for watching.